We have a rainstorm that just came in. A few days ago, it was probably about 100 degrees. Now we have a torrential downpour.
Sophie, what are we gonna do? We're not gonna be able to go for a walk. Huh? What are we gonna do? Sophie, you wanna come outside?
You're not having any of it, huh? So we got a break from the rainstorm. Look at that. But you see it over there still. It comes up over that hill right there from the north.
Little baby.
I was just trying to think of something to talk about on the walk, so I figure I'll bring this one up. I want to talk about Donald Trump.
No.
We're going to go get Lotus a passport right now. We have an appointment and we're running late, like usual. So we're running late and...
How late are we running?
We're pretty late.
We'll be back, Sophie, so you watch the house, okay? It's a lot of responsibility. She always gets bummed out when we get ready to leave. Oh, we'll be back.
We are out the door in a flash. We went to the passport office. We're taking a trip to Bulgaria this summer. So, here's Lotus's little passport photo. She was asleep, and so we had to take her out. Look at little Lotus's foot. I'm sure she's gonna love it later on in life when she sees this vlog and this picture, but I figured I'd show it.
We just did a little shopping trip, and nowadays I buy certain things. Oh, are you getting fussy? I buy some things in advance because I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do a trip. Oh, you don't like to be held like this. If daddy holds her like this, she likes it. If I hold her like this, she doesn't care for it. This, I love it because it foams for like lattes or cocoa. I still like my foamy lattes and cocoa, so I buy this. I got apples, organic melons, organic apples, organic zucchini, organic broccoli. So the produce is organic and organic bananas. Whenever I can, I buy organic. Obviously, when I travel, I don't.
I am here at Beverly Hot Springs. I'm not sure how long this place has been around, but it's the only spring water in Los Angeles. It's real hot water with a cold dipping pool and a sauna and a steam room. So this place is actually really, 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 really healing. It's kind of nice having access to spring water in the city. I started coming here, I think it was probably like 27 years ago, maybe. And back then, it was before I discovered yoga, but I had some injuries, mainly a back injury. And this is like the beginning of my healing journey right here. There was a blind Korean guy that was a shiatsu masseuse. And he's the one that kind of made me realize like you can get out of pain. And because I thought it was some kind of nerve damage or something because my back wouldn't stop hurting. And I think I was only like 20 years old, but his name is Dr. Ham, and he actually was pretty life changing. And then from there I started doing yoga and discovered breathing and also transcendental meditation. Wrapped up at the Beverly Hot Springs. So what I try and do is I try and soak in the hot water and then go sit in the cold water. The cold water is real ice cold. And my brother's been telling me about, he's been taking like cold showers every day. I can't get myself to do cold showers, but that the ice cold water is really therapeutic. I grew up surfing too, so it's like in the winter when you surf, the water is like probably 50, 55 degrees. And there's times where, you know, it's real big waves, and especially when you're paddling out, there's resistance to taking a wave over the top of your head because it's ice cold water and you literally get like an ice cream headache. So this cold water, soaking in it, I kind of use it as like an exercise to stay in it till I'm shivering, and then also to, you know, hold my breath under it, just for like breath control and stuff. So that's good. And then the sauna, I try and do at least 20 minutes in the sauna, and then at least two like 5-10 minute sit downs in the steam room. Right now I've been kind of intermittent fasting too, so I haven't eaten yesterday since I think I ate around 6 in the afternoon yesterday, and today it's probably like 4 right now, so it's going towards 24 hours. So I'm having like a lot of clarity actually. A little bit of a headache, which I think is kind of like a detox headache, but I feel real light. There's points in there where I felt like I didn't even feel my body. I felt real light, felt really good.
While Johnny is at the hot springs here, I'm working on my pregnancy program. It's almost done. Those are just the picture files for the program, poses for leg cramps and back pain and so forth. My Photoshop skills are not that great, but I'm doing what I can do with it. Right, Sophie? I have a cool question for you and for everybody, really. Vlogging is awesome because you're creating memories for yourself or for the future. So if you're right now creating a memory for yourself for the next five years, what is this going to be? And you guys can post in the comments below. You can leave a message to yourself 5 years from now. What would you tell yourself 5 years from now if you were to watch this vlog and you're basically leaving a message to yourself?
What would you tell yourself?
I haven't thought about that. I thought it's like a cool thing to see in 5 years. I have no idea. Go for it. Do you have a message for yourself?
Yeah, this is what I tell myself, I would say. Take it easy, Johnny. Everything's okay. You're doing good.
I'll tell myself, I'll just remind myself of the joy that, you know, I feel. Just keep that joy.
When you reflect back on the past, you realize you're living in like magical moments, you know? Yeah. And then you have that nostalgia. But the present's the same way.
It's the same, yeah. You're gonna look back on this and again say.
Exactly.
Right now, I have the same nostalgia towards the present.
What the hell?
Answer this question and you may pass.
Who are you?
Just answer the question, tough guy. Does a squirrel have Buddha
what?
Nature?
Yes.
That's right. Have a nice day.
Man, that was weird. Allie ran to the store and she left me alone with the little dragon. So I only have a few tools at my disposal to fend off the little dragon, but this is her. Allie and I each got about 4 hours of sleep last night. So there she is. What are you up to, huh? She was up till I think probably 3 or 4 in the morning. She gets all wound up at night. Her pupils get dilated and she gets a little rosy cheeks and real active and wants to talk. So it's about 9 a.m. right now and she just woke up. So she sleeps like 6 hours though, which is pretty good.
What are you doing? What are you doing? Do you see yourself there? Do you see yourself? Look. Yeah. Even little Sophie was up till 3 in the morning. So even Sophie can't escape the wrath of the dragon.
You're up till what?
She kept me up till 3 o'clock.
Yeah. I went to bed too, but I got up at 6, which is...
It was so funny because she, like, at 12 she gets going and she gets, like, real happy. And at some point I pass out and I'm just kind of asleep. And I look over at her and she's like this. Her eyes are bright open and she's just waiting for Ian to start smiling and talking. I'm like, yeah, let's sleep. Let's do this tomorrow. And she's like...
Let's go, I'm ready.
Yeah. It's like her prime, most happiest and most like.
Yeah. Just as long as she doesn't do that when she's a teenager, we're fine. This is the little being that beat the hell out of 3 other beings last night. Look how innocent she looks too. Yeah. Even Sophie didn't sleep. Yeah, none of us got any sleep last night.
She's just discovered her hands. So we don't even need to entertain her anymore. Look at her, Johnny. She's just staring at her hands. Hey. Who is that? When you discover your own hands.
So funny.
That's funny, Lodi. That's so funny, Lodi. Yeah. That's so funny, Mama.
Those are called hands. Look at that.
She's just in disbelief. We had such a rough day today, I feel, because I slept only 4 hours. I shot a class, actually, and I edited it, and it's done. And I received a comment, and I just was going to say something. Someone said, yeah, but it's so easy for you, Ali. There is other moms that, you recovered quickly. There's other moms that take a long time, and they suffer depression and stuff. No, guys, it hasn't been easy. It's never easy for anybody. It's... I possibly don't complain online and I try to focus on what inspires me, but it wasn't easy. And especially when I got pregnant, I had so many challenges with YouTube and my work. hasn't been easy. And even though I may seem in shape or fit or whatever to some of you, I'm not even 60% to where I used to be. So to me, and where I was, I still have probably 6 months to go. And it's not easy. It's a daily thing. It's not easy for any one of us. And I just try to put out positivity. I'm not trying to hide my struggles. I just try not to burden people with my struggles. Here and there, I share them when I'm ranting. But in general, I just try to share the positive. And there's always positive in every situation, and I tend to see it. So I try to share that. But I just wanted to say it hasn't been easy, and I don't ever think it's easy for anyone.
Kiss is coming. It's coming. It's coming. Slowly. It's coming. A kiss is coming. Here it goes. It's coming, Mama.
So Ali challenged me to doing 50 vacuums a day, and she's basically saying that it can make your waistline a lot thinner. So I haven't even really done them, so I'm gonna try it right now. So I'm gonna do a vacuum right now and just see if it works. Didn't seem to work. All joking aside, I know you can't thin your waist out from using a vacuum cleaner, so just being silly. So I'm actually gonna do some vacuums.